Oh, you know what that opening means. Our buddy AJ Petiti is here from the one and only Petiti's Garden Center. Welcome back, AJ.
Good, sir.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You're talking potted plants. And thank goodness, after all that frost and freeze, at least you can bring them inside if you need to.
If you need to, it's easy. You know, hopefully, knock on wood, you grant us
reprieve,
we're good and we're done. but if something does happen, just cover with a bed sheet. They're really easy to take care of.
Thrillers, spillers.
And fillers.
And fillers.
Yeah, container
garden.
So you can do so much in a container, you know, and especially with everybody, you know, bringing the living room outside and with outdoor living, you know, it's really a wonderful thing to bring as much as you can, really, right in the containers, right on the patio, you know, protects it from the deer. There's really not a lot of issues that way. And you can do so much in a container. So speaking of which, so this is actually a raspberry bush, and they've been breeding these guys actually to go into containers. So this is designed, you can plant it in the ground. We actually have one right next to the Fox 8 Garden on the other side. But it's a raspberry bush that's really meant to be inside of a container. And you can actually see the little buds are right there, so it's getting ready to flower, and you know,
ooh,
we'll have fruit
nice.
On there this summer. So these guys are awesome. And then you could do all kinds of vegetables, your herbs, these tomatoes. Actually, you can kind of see the little baby tomatoes coming on here. So this guy's ready to fruit and loaded for bear. So
my strawberries are already hanging off the.
Oh, yeah.
Those are ready to go.
I
can't wait.
When you go to do a tomato, though, and really any vegetable, you want to make sure that you've got a big enough container. So this is about a 16-inch pot. That's about as small as I would go.
Do you transplant them eventually?
Yeah. You just leave that right inside the container. And then, you know, you plant it right in, and then just make sure you put a tomato cage or some kind of support. But you can do everything. Peppers, cucumbers, you know, tomato, obviously, you know, basil and parsley and everything else.
Okay.
And so it's really easy. And you could really plant a container in anything. This is an old watering can. You can plant it in that. You can do.
That's neat.
People use shoes. You could use hats. You can use, as long as it has drainage, that's really the key thing.
Wayne Dawson has so many shoes.
Oh, could you imagine?
Older than us.
Boom.
Oh. Yeah, I mean.
You can really get creative and have a lot of fun as you're going through. So what we're going to talk about, so this is just a really nice pot. It's fiber clay. There's a lot of lightweight containers that are out there.
Right.
The one important thing, you want to make sure that there's a drain hole. So when you're going to look at your containers, that's really a critical factor. So you want to make sure that there's something at the bottom for that water to get out. And then either put rocks, you can use styrofoam, not a huge fan of it just because it's styrofoam, but rocks at the bottom, you need to have drainage. So this is actually, it's called an upsidaisy, and it's a false bottom for your pot, so it just sits right in. And what's great about those, you can reuse them year over year over year, and you'll be in good shape. So as you go to do that, you want to, this is actually really important. You know, as it comes with the garden, with planting anything, it's really all about soil preparation, and you only get one chance to do it right.
Yeah, so, one shot at the beginning.
And so you want to make sure that you're using a nice soilless mix. So you don't want to use any kind of heavy soils. You know, save the compost for the garden, not really for your containers. And definitely, absolutely do not use topsoil or anything that's heavy like that. You really want to avoid it.
So got some flowers, you've got a...
Yeah, so this is actually a juniper. So it's not a traditional thriller, filler, spiller, but this is... You know, you can get creative, and putting, especially like trees and shrubs inside your containers, what's beautiful about this is this, you can plant it, enjoy it all season, and then really just transition it out to the garden after you're done with the season. So it's a great way to prolong, and you can do roses, do all kinds of stuff in your containers.
Now it's that season again, AJ. We're talking about flower bombing again.
Oh, beautiful.
So I can't believe it's here again already. So we're flower bombing.
Yeah, so we're taking submissions right now. So go ahead, do your submissions to fox8.com if there's somebody that you want to nominate, and we'll go out and we'll just kind of make their day. And then next week.
You guys are doing the garden too,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, really we're doing soon. That next week. So
exciting times.
Yeah, can't wait.
Oh, man.
So be good.
I love this time of the year. It's so beautiful. And Wayne, Stephanie, Christy, I'll tell you, what a beautiful time with all these colors. It's gorgeous.
Yeah.
Can't wait.
Awesome. AJ, I was just going to say, pass along, Petiti's have really helped support us with Cleveland Clinic Children's Hospital and raising a lot of money and donating, which has been so nice.
They are. They have such a heart,
they
their whole family. They really do.
And the
really
flower
do.
Bomb,
yeah.
These strangers.
Yeah. So nice.
Homes,
right?
Yeah, so nice.
Really great people.